So the national anthem all done with as we get set for the opening face-off of the Battalion home opener. As we talk just at the end, just before the national anthem, Chad Wiseman and Jason Spenta, two big guys that need to put the puck in the net for this Ice Dog team to be successful. Two other guys, of course, would be Chris Thaler wearing number 26 and a young man they picked up from Kitchener, I believe, Mike Wierstead. Wierstead was a highly touted kid coming out of the Bantam ranks and really didn't meet up to expectations last season, but this year has come out flying and fits on perfectly with the line with Jason Spezza.
Yeah, Wierstead seems to be a kid who might not have been given a full opportunity in Kitchener, but he's really seemed to have blossomed already in the preseason, an outstanding preseason playing along with Spezza and Wiseman, and I mean, only big things to come from this guy, I think. Another guy that they picked up in the offseason, Brett Angel, who we will be talking to a little bit later on in today's game. But Angel was acquired, of course, from London in exchange for Lou Dickinson. And Angel seems to have been maybe the solidifying force back there on their blue line.
The starting goaltenders for tonight's hockey game for the Battalion, of course, David Chant. Chant saw the majority of ice time last year, almost 2,800 minutes between the pipes, and of course was in the net for the 2-2 draw in Mississauga on Friday. And at the other end of the rink for the Ice Dogs, wearing number 30, is Michael Mole. And Mole, as we talked about, fabulous in the beginning of the season so far for the Ice Dogs. Outstanding in the first one. Mole had led the Ice Dogs with 5 wins last year and, of course, had a save percentage of .850. So Michael Mole in the net between the pipes for the Ice Dogs. Kicking things off up front for the Battalion. You've got at center Jay McClement. On the left side is number 9, Adam Henrich. And Henrich is the younger brother of Mike Henrich, former Barry Colts. And on the right side is Aaron Van Loosen wearing number 21. Standing things up on the defense, Captain Jay Malenko is number 4. And on the right side of the defense, Brad Woods wears number 8. Two veteran defensemen that are going to be counted on for big things for the Battalion. Up front for the Ice Dogs, as expected, you've got Jason Spezza at center ice. Dalladay wears number 7. Also out there is Omar Enafati wearing number 11. And of course, it is number 21. That is Chad Wiseman. He of the glorious opportunity and the breakaway in overtime Friday night. Joining them, Mike Wierstead. And Wierstead is going to be playing. This is the big line for the Ice Dogs. This is the number one line that the Battalion need to contain. Spezza and McClement move in the face-off circle as we'll kick off the 2000-2001 campaign at home for the Brampton Battalion. Off the opening face-off, puck goes inside the Battalion end. Malenko back to pick it up, stops, sets up a breakout pattern. McClement leaves it, and it comes around the boards to Brad Woods. Woods dumps it through the middle. Van Loosen from center ice can't get it past Dalladay as it's played back to Spezza through the center ice area. Jarrett across the blue line, tipped ahead. Spezza knocked off stride, then bounced to the ice. Wiseman for Spezza. He takes the hit from Bateman. Malenko can't get it. Woods dives. Here's a break at the side. They score! Mike Wierstead. So just 2 minutes and 15 seconds, or 3 minutes and 15 seconds into this hockey game, the Mississauga Ice Dogs have jumped out to a 1-0 lead.
And that's the man we talked about, Mike Wierstead, one of the guys who will be leading the charge this year for the Mississauga Ice Dogs. And we saw the Battalion defense break down just a little bit when they were coming back the other way, as Woods dove to try and grab a hold of his man. It was just out of his reach, and there was Wierstead all alone on the other side, and Chant was just a little bit behind the play sliding across.
This is Grenier dumping it in the corner. Bonus. The young rookie for the Battalion charges into the corner, comes back to Flash. Lets it fly, scores! Paul Flash! Boy, what a great job by Chris Rowan in front of the net. To cause a little confusion, Michael Mole didn't even see the shot coming, and Flash did his job, letting a low, hard shot go right on the net.
Yeah, Rowan, a guy we've expected a lot more out of this season, a guy who's just been waiting to explode, and he's doing his job now there. He's a big body down in front of the net, as we saw, as we'll see on the replay coming up here. Paul Flash, delivered a nice low shot that it seemed Michael Mole, I don't know, he looked like he was a little bit behind the puck. There was a whole lot of room down low on that glove side where Flash beat him.
So a 1-1 tie here in the first period, 13 minutes to go. Thomas McSwain tips it by. Labor goes to the ice, back in front, Rice can't get full wood on it, finally a shot, they shoot again, big save, and Michael Mole covers up. Glorious opportunity in front of the Ice Dogs net. McClement's got Henrich with him. McClement to the outside. Henrich heads to the net. Leaves it to the side. Van Leusen can't control it. Gets the puck back. In front, they score! Adam Henrich! That's the first goal of the OHL campaign for Adam Henrich. The young rookie picking up his first OHL marker.
And there we see again the Brampton Battalion putting all kinds of pressure on Michael Mole and the Mississauga defense, crashing the net again, and this time it pays off. They had the opportunity to send the puck back out to the point, but again, here you'll see Van Leusen cut back, takes a second opportunity and just dishes out in front, and Henrich is right there to send the puck by a sprawling Michael Mole, and everybody just a little bit too late to help out as the Battalion have now taken a 2-1 lead.
For the Battalion, behind the net for Henrich, steps right out. Henrich back for McClement, backhand shot, Mole again up to the task. His way to the boards and picks up the puck. Wiseman gets it back to the blue line. Spezza with time, lets it fly. Grenier got a piece of that one. Spezza again, huge glove save from David Chan. 30 seconds remain in the Battalion penalty to Chris Rowan. Control of it. Loose puck in the slot area and a breakout, 2-on-1. Spezza and Wiseman. Wiseman to Spezza, right open, goes off the side of the net. Chant got a piece of it. Boy, Wiseman with a great opportunity. Looked like Chant was back on his heels. Hovel sidesteps a check, here's a break. Lucas Hovel, right in on goal, backhand. Mole comes up big and steers it aside. And Bateman comes away with the puck. Bonus in Bateman. Bateman cuts to the middle, still has it tied up, loose puck. Grenier shot and score! Matt Grenier! Once again, another opportunity for the Battalion deep inside of the Ice Dogs and is capitalized finally by Matt Grenier.
Hey, talk about being in the right place at the right time. It appeared as though Jeff Bateman was tied up on the play, but Grenier following in as the trailer, able to scoop up that loose puck, and now the shots sit at 33-13 in favor of Brampton, and you just had to wonder when this was gonna happen. And the answer is, with 8:34 to go in the second period, and we'll take a look at the replay now. As we'll see, Bateman cut across, he gets a face full of mitt there, and there's the puck laying loose at the hash marks, and Grenier will just let a quick snapper go that beats Michael Mole. He had no chance on it.
Both Ice Dog defensemen really pinching into the top of the circle as the Battalion seem to just fall back in front of the net. There's the shot, they score, Chad Wiseman.
Yeah, we seem to see Mississauga keep trying to creep in and force that Battalion triangle to collapse. And eventually, once they started to work the puck around a little bit wider, actually, then they got it back down in close. And Wiseman at the side door, able to slam it in. And now, of course, quickly, Mississauga down by just a goal.
Well, it was very important for this hockey club to get a quick goal on the 5-on-3, and that's simply because now they're still on a power play for a buck 18 as Wiseman drills it into the open cage. Tie up Enifati, goes into the corner for Wurstead, back for Wiseman, back for Enifati with time, lets it go right on, Chant with the save. Another shot, they score! The circle and ripped it just inside the post. We're all tied at 3. 2 power play markers for the Ice Dogs, even the score.
And as we saw Friday night, the Ice Dogs jumped all over their chances early on in the third period to draw things even at 2 and basically play their way to a 2-2 tie. And here in the second period, they get a great chance again. Up 2 men, and they capitalize on both power play opportunities. And of course, that's Patrick Jarrett's first OHL goal. And that goal has drawn the Battalion and the Ice Dogs even at 3, and we've got a brand new ball game here, Dougie.
Well, Jared elects to just step into this one, and he let it fly as you see it beat David Chant on the blocker side. So 2 quick goals again for the Ice Dogs. 2:68 in Mississauga to tie the game at 2, and 2 here in under a minute and a half. to tie this game at 3. Flash opens up a little room to the outside. Paul Flash right in. Rebound. Big save as Moule comes up huge in the Dogs' net. Flash lets it go. Rips it over top of the net. Comes to Thompson with time. Harrison now has it. His wrist shot deflected. It goes wide. McClement has the puck. McClement in the corner takes the hit from Wiseman. McClement follows up. No one in front of the net as McSwain gets dumped. Buckley's back on the ice. They score! Jay McClement! Just as the penalty ended to Buckley, he was heading back. Jay McClement puts it in the net for a one-goal lead. And Edafati and Angel are now back on the ice. So the Battalion come away with one goal in that 5-on-3 opportunity. Here's McClement at the side of the net. Feeds it out to McSwain in front. And I'll tell you something, it was Coughlin battling with Thompson that made this all happen. McClement got 4 cracks at it before putting it past Michael Moule. Grenier will wheel away again. Around the boards, Bonus takes the hit from Angel, but the puck comes all the way down the ice. Coming up front as well, just in case McSwain gets waved out of the circle. Stalemate, but Jarrett plows through. Plays the puck into the corner. Hanchuk takes a slap at it. McSwain clears it. Right out in front. Loose puck. Cleared to the side. Jarrett gets it for Wiseman. Centering pass. McClement can't clear the zone. And a loose puck. Here's McSwain. He's got Rice with him. Gets Rice the pass. Open net. And Rice can't tip it in. With the goalie pulled for the Ice Dogs, Rice had the open net and couldn't get the pass from Kurt McSwain. Hanchuk gets it back to the center ice area. There's the shot, and it goes wide. 5 seconds remain in the period, and the Battalion will walk away with their first win of the season and are still undefeated after 2. A win and a tie against the Mississauga Ice Dogs. The Brampton fans very happy as the Battalion come out with a 4-3 victory. Outplayed the Ice Dogs for the first period and a half, and then right on target, the Ice Dogs come back in the second period, tying the game at 3 with 2 power play markers in a 5-3 advantage. A whole different game until Matt Grenier put it away with 16 seconds to go in the period. No scoring in the third period, but I'll tell you folks, what an exciting third period as the Ice Dogs turn it up a notch, but come away on the shy end of a 4-3 decision. We're going to come back with our 3-star selection here at the Brampton Center. Once again, after a 52-25 shots on goal, a 4-3 victory for the Battalion in the Brampton Center. Stay with us on OHL Primetime. We'll come back with the 3-star selection and tonight's first star. Stay with us on Rogers.
The big goal tonight, but we have to look back to just before that when Mississauga struck for a couple of power play goals there. And how did you guys respond? What did you guys do on the bench? I mean, after they had scored those goals.
Well, you know, we kind of had a little letdown there, and the same thing happened to us the other night in Mississauga. They scored 2 quick goals, and we knew we really had to stay out of the box. I think they scored all their goals tonight on the power play, so we knew we had to just stay out of the box. And I don't know, we just kind of came together there, and we knew what we had to do, and we just went out and did it.
Now, when Mississauga came out with that flurry at the start of the third period, did you guys think, oh, no, it's Friday night all over again?
I think so, yeah, but I don't know. We went through it once before, and we kind of knew how to deal with it. We knew just work shift by shift and start winning our one-on-one battles, and things would come out for us.
Now, what's the team's attitude right now, knowing that Rafi Torres and Rusty Kleslo could be coming back? What's the attitude in the room right now?
Well, I don't know. I guess we gotta work through that right now and just play as good as we can right now without them, and if they come back, that's great. If not, I think we're looking pretty good right now too. So either way, we're gonna be all right.
Okay, Jay, thanks a lot. Great game today, and congratulations.
Thanks a lot.
All right, Jay McClement, tonight's first star. We'll throw things back up to Doug Anderson to wrap it up.
Thanks, Hammer. So the three stars for tonight, Jason Maleko, the third star, Patrick Jarrett from the Mississauga Ice Dogs, second star tonight, and Matt Grenier, that was our first star, his interview with the Hammer, Mike Hancock. And we'll take a look at, that was Jay McClement, and we'll take a look at Jay McClement's goal, a big goal to win this hockey game for the Battalion. I'll tell you something, folks, the Battalion really, after giving up two goals on a 5-on-3 situation, had better to throw things back in there, and they came out with Jay McClement coming up with the big goal. Here's the scoring summary for the game with Werstedt, Jarrett, and Nenafati on the power play to kick things off. Flash got the goal for Brampton. Henrik the second goal to make it 2-1. Grenier the third goal. A 3-1 lead then. Wiseman and Jarrett on that power play, and McClement comes up with the last one of the evening. So the honorary mentions in the stars should go as well to Michael Mole, who faced 52 shots in this hockey game. A 4-3 Brampton Battalion victory. Everything's great after your home opener when you win on home ice. The Battalion, a 4-3 win for the Hammer, Mike Hancock. I'm Doug Anderson. For the rest of the crew here on OHL Primetime, thanks for joining us, and we'll see you against the Guelph Storm.